Hey guys, WolfSpectre here with GameHolio.com. Today I will be giving you my initial impressions on Tom Clancy's The Division. Developer Ubisoft put this game out, and they've been trying to put it together for the last, I don't know, 3 to 5 years. And it's a very hyped game. People have been waiting for this for a long time. And it's very ambitious. It's got an enormous amount of content in it. And it's just an impressive game all around. It's an MMO, an RPG, and a cover-based third-person shooter all rolled into one. Oh, and a co-op one on top of that. So, basically what happens here is you're an operator for the Division, which the government has put into place in the instance that a Armageddon-type terrorist attack happens in the U.S., and that's what happens in Manhattan. Terrorist attack on Black Friday. By putting a virus on all of the money, and it circulates throughout the city on Black Friday and just cripples the city, causing Armageddon in town. And that's when the game takes place. You take control of a division operator, and you're sent to kind of quell, you know, slow everything down and try and stop everything from happening. And there's just murder and blood and guts and all this everywhere. So I'll try and get through as much as I can. I'll try and hit the main points. It's a very good game. It's worth the money. If you're thinking about buying this game, I'm going to tell you before you listen to the rest of this that you should just go get it. But just to give you an idea what the game's all about, the first thing that happens is when you take control of the operator, you get to kind of a light character creation. This is one of my only beefs with the game, is there's not a lot of character creation that you can really do. You can change, there's I think 5 or 6 faces, and you can add some facial hair and some war paint, and that's really all you can do. Moving on from there, the attention to detail in the game is just, as I said, it's pretty astounding. Anything from the posters to the sheer amount of garbage in the streets, so the cars, you know, as it being in New York, I believe Ubisoft actually took the time, you know, to see what traffic would be like in certain situations, and you can tell because there's just vehicles everywhere, doors open, which is another really impressive thing. If you take cover against the door and move along the side of it, you can actually slide the door shut to get it out of your way so you can peer over the vehicle with your gun. It's the little things like that that make it really impressive, because it is an MMO and it's such a big game. Just the small attention to the details like that is pretty astonishing, really. Dogs barking in the streets, you know, people fighting blocks down. Everything about it is really excellent. Gun sounds are also, they're not as, I wouldn't say they're as good as most Tom Clancy games, because they're very sharp in every Tom Clancy game, and that's another one of my beefs, I guess. The gun sounds aren't that great, but it's, as I said, that's very minor to the main point of the game. You can mod the guns, various amounts of guns that you can choose from, so the sound, it's a minor beef, as I said before. The controls themselves are very solid. I think, I'm playing it on PS4 right now, I think it runs at 30 frames per second, and it runs good. I never ran into any glitches or anything like that. I believe on computer, on PC, it probably runs at 60 frames per second. And I think Bane himself has a game on PC and said that he could run it at a higher aspect ratio as well, which is pretty impressive. Being on PS4 and Xbox, the sheer amount of detail they were able to cram into the game without too much performance drop is really impressive. The mechanics are fantastic in the game. There's a cover system, obviously. It's a cover-based shooter, so the cover system is really well done. It's one of the best I've had the joy of playing with. It's very streamlined, very smooth. It's, I guess, somewhat like you could compare it to Gears of War, but it's way smoother than that. It's not as clunky, I guess you could say. At the beginning of the game, they take you through, you know, somewhat of a training mission to kind of get your grips and kind of teach you the mechanics of the game. And there's a couple missions you do before they actually unleash you into your real base operations located in Manhattan. You know, you'll have inventory stuff there and gear, mods, and everything you can change there. The sheer amount of loot in the game from each mission you go to, even the side missions, you can get loot from just about everything. It's pretty much insane the amount of content that they've jammed into this. I'm going to keep saying that. In most of the missions, you can find, you know, the varying level in most MMOs and RPGs. You know, you'll have your your lighter characters to all the way up to an elite character, you know, the enemies that are harder to kill, in which obviously they will drop better loot. As it is an RPG, you have a skill tree and you have three to choose from. There's also perks for the skills that you choose, so it's fairly deep, and you're not bound to just one skill. You can actually respec as you see fit whenever you feel the need. And that was a really smart thing they did, because when you're playing with different people and you're co-oping together, you want to kind of have that freedom to, you want to be able to do whatever you want to do. So as far as the multiplayer goes, it's referred to as the Dark Zone in the game. I haven't got to touch it, so I don't really know anything about it. I'll touch on that next time, because this will be a series of reviews to actually put together. My initial offering here is that it's a very good game, obviously. Co-oping, I did a couple, I joined with a couple of friends, and it was very simple to do. You basically just open up your HUD, join your teammate, and then wherever you're at on the map, you can fast travel to them and do missions with them at any time as well. So it's very simple. The basic premise of this is that it's a very impressive game. It's very ambitious, and the amount of content that they've crammed into it is absolutely tremendous. I'll be interested to see what they do for endgame content after level 30. For more on The Division, check back at GameHolio.com. Thanks.